Greetings, minions. I am your humble narrator, Sideways Thinker. And I'm just here with some more Let's Play Aviary Attorney. Let's be reasonable, senors. I'm sure this is a simple misunderstanding. Yes, we just started the next day. Standing in the name of the king, arrest that Spaniard. Oh, balls, it's a Spaniard. We're going to have to defend the Spaniard, aren't we? Are we going to have to defend the Spaniard? Fox Among Wolves, Act 2. Yes. We're going to have to defend the fucking Spaniard, aren't we? Damn it, why can't I defend a proper Englishman in France? Falcon Philip turned into the office on Friday. I do actually wonder what Sparrison's specific job actually is. Do you know what I mean? Like, because I get what Falcon does, but is Sparrison just his assistant? Like, is that his job title? It's midday on Monday, but there's still no sign of him. Yeah, you probably shouldn't have led in with, I knew he wouldn't come in on Friday. They made it sound very, not serious. Oh, we're picking Sparrison's actions. Okay. I should wait around a little. Be the lazy shit you are, Sparrison. Yeah, he's a big bird. He is in fact, Big Bird. He's not a Big Bird, he's the Big Bird. Wait a little longer. Little longer. No, I want to see if the game will stop me. Little longer. The game's not going to stop me, is it? No, again, not going to stop me. This is boring. Probably go find him. Yeah, because otherwise we're going to be wandering around backwards and forwards in this fucking room for the rest of the time. So it'll be a good place to start with. The bird burying never gave me his address. I have to find him the hard way. Detectiving! Detectivering. Okay, let's check la conciergerie. La conciergerie. Someone actually tried to correct me on my pronunciation of this, and I have decided to ignore them deliberately. I probably said, feel free to help me with pronunciation, but I've decided, nah, fuck it. Look like a lost and found to you. Buzz off, bird brain. You're a bird. You are both, by definition, bird brain. Okay, let's go back to the office we just left, see what's there. Nope, still no sign of him. Oh, I hope the game would be like, ah, don't know why I came back. Oh, can I do it again? Is it just going to give me the same message? Yeah. Okay, let's go to the place where Monsieur Grandoui was killed. Excuse me, Mademoiselle Duhout, however the fuck. Look down, you mad bitch. You're a giraffe. There should be a... Oh, God, she's got normal hands as well. It's so fucking weird. Oh, there you are. It's Sparrison, right? Yes, that's right. I'm tiny and have creepy man hands. You're involved in... No one thought the Baron was a murderer. He always treated me with utmost respect. Yeah, problem is, he wasn't a murderer, was he? Anyway, since the killers are the ones who have put the best facade. Yeah. Seemed a little down last night. Oh, you've seen him? Yes, he was brooding in the corner of Le Canard Joyeux. Joyux. Lay Canard Joyux. I'm just going to start deliberately pronouncing these wrong. Lay Canard Joyux. That's the dingy student bar on the Rue Jayune, right? It's not dingy, it's just a little rustic, and I guess it's enormous help, thank you. Bye, Mademoiselle. But apparently we can still check the Palace of Justice. The Palace de Justice. Or whatever the fuck. I don't know how it's pronounced in France. But in French. Sound of Falcon here. Excuse me, Rupert. You shit. The first year dropout. I didn't drop out. I failed. Yeah, possibly a Oh. Sorry, that just gave me an awful flashback as to what happened to me when I was in college. For those who don't know, I was kicked out my first year. Bad attendance. I'm in university now, though, and I did get I did go back and get all my stuff. Same college. Don't know why they accepted me. I don't Not a clue. Doesn't matter right now. Looking for Falcon. Have you seen him? Falcon, the guy who blundered his way through the Catiline trial with the help of some, very dubious evidence. Oh, don't be such a fucking prick. Like, okay, the fact that he's wearing gloves make his hands a lot less creepy. Is this why cartoon animals always wear gloves? Is this possibly one of the reasons that they're bare hands? If you put any detail on, that's really fucking weird. Also, that hat's much too big for you. And since the trial. Oh, well, thanks anyway, you hoppy little swine. Oh, dear. Fucking... I'm tired. Why am I tired? Okay, let's go to the Lay Canard Joyux. It's a dodo, isn't it? Ah, creepy fat baby hands. Steps through the doors of Lay Canard Joyux, the dingiest student tavern in all of Paris. His nostrils fill the pungent aroma of sour wine and bitter tobacco and this massive flower. Well, ruffle my feathers, visiting little sparrows. I haven't seen you in years. How are you doing, hun? Q and Ellie! Hello, madame Q and Ellie. How are you? She had to find a friend. He's a big guy named JJ Falcon. Falcon? Yep, that's right. Lump has been here all weekend. He's been moaning and muttering to himself all weekend. Frankly, he's bringing the whole atmosphere down. I'll take care of him. A rifle round to the back of the head. Madame Quanelli. No problem, honey. He'll probably see. He's probably still in the corner of the drinking room. Fuck you, card room! I have no idea what he is. A hideously morbidly obese dog, maybe? Here to play some Jacques Noir, are you, monsieur? No, not right now, looking for my friend. Big drunk fellow, spotted him downstairs. Well, thank you, yes. Yes, you can go up there and play Jacques Noir with them. My dear, I almost stepped on the big fellow. Falcon, what are you doing on the floor? Falcon, wake up. Well, the bird's completely out cold. It's the drunkest place dry at sea. How do you wake a drunk person? Kick him! Nope, nothing. Kick him! Nope, nothing. Yell at him! Good! No. Nope, nothing. Kick it! Sorry. Pour a drink on his head. It's time for a rude awakening. Wakey, wakey, you sleepy fucking drunk. They got more use out of the damp JJ Falcon drawing. Hey, good, you're up. Are, you with us? Yes. Yes, I am. My plumage still kind of looks like I've got mutton chops, though. And sober, we should probably head back to the AV office so we can get some work done. I don't understand it, Sparrowson. I thought I did everything right. I followed all the procedures, I found all the evidence, I presented the case beautifully. Yeah, the guilty feline walks free while an innocent man sits in custody. What went wrong? Where's the justice? Surely you could, like, go to the authorities and be like, yeah, about, like, half an hour after that trial, Dame Catiline actually just openly said that she was the killer? So we should probably get her slapped in irons, given that she's openly admitted to a murder now. We need to try harder. You clearly weren't looking at it well enough. Don't have messed up or the system messed up or what, but we just have to do our best as lawyers, I suppose. Actually, no, it was actually completely beyond our control. That one. She was just apparently very good at framing him. She managed to frame him in such a way that it looked like he was framing her. Like, it's quite an impressive job. Sorry, Falcon, don't have the answers, but what I do have is freshly baked croissants from Pierre's. No, I know how about this boulangerie. Because that's, because I remember there's a lot of jokes on, not so much anymore, but there used to be a lot of jokes on British television about bread in panties. You know, because it involves the word lingerie. It's the most pretentious way of saying underwear. I believe, however, when you say lingerie in England, you're specifically talking about stuff that's supposed to look a bit sexy, you know what I mean? But, like, I don't know. I'm sitting here moaning about justice and you offer me croissants. I don't... croissants. Sorry. Croissants. 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 I'm sitting here moaning about justice and you offer me croissants. Well, it's not just croissants. I got you some Payne's Ow Chocolate, too. I could go for some Payne's Ow Chocolate. Fantastic. Let's make a move. It's kind of difficult to deliberately mispronounce. So, like, shit that I know. Like, I know how croissant is pronounced. And yes, I am one of those people who doesn't call it croissant, so I go croissant, because, croissant. I'm sure I'm pronouncing it wrong. But I think I've talked about this before, is that if I know how to pronounce a word in its own language, I'll pronounce it as best I can in the language. Told you. Pierre's Boulangerie on Rue Verde is something else. Oh, that reminds me, the baker told me something interesting. Do you know why they call, what they call Payne's Au Chocolat in America? Don't call it Payne's Au Chocolat, nope. Pronunciation difficulties. American is a whole nother language. What do they call them? Chocolate croissant. Croissants. Stand on it. Hello? Chocolate croissants. What do they call profiteroles? Yeah, we still call them profiteroles. Simply outstanding. What do they call creeps? Excuse me! Did you just hear something, Sparrowson? Down here. Oh, sorry, I didn't see you there. I'm gonna consume you, because you're exactly what falcons eat. Gosh, where to start? Your name, perhaps? Mousy. Well, we already know. By the way, that is the worst name. What do we do for you, Mr. Mousy? I have a friend, fallen under some legal turbulence. He's been arrested. Yes. He's a murderer, but he did. Wait, they say he's a murderer, but he did not. He didn't kill anyone. It's quite a problem. Bit of a pickle. Not really my area of expertise. Bye. I know, but I forgot to mention he's the Prince of Spain. The Prince of Spain. I forgot to mention that my friend is the Prince of Spain. Yeah, because this mouse wearing a rag and like a stick looks like a beggar. Totally the kind of guy who hangs out with the Prince of Spain, isn't he? Let's ask Massey, why did you come to us? I would have thought that the Spanish royal family would hire legal counsel with a little more not terribleness. Well, we... Well, okay. We're defense attorneys. And a defense attorney's job is completely amoral. It's to keep their client out of prison. You did a good job. You kept her out of prison even though she did it. But it's a great thing, your lawyering skills, Monsieur Falcon. He said your reputation as a lawyer was renowned. Really? The prince said that? That's a great opportunity, Falcon. Surely you wouldn't deny a request from the Prince of Spain. Meh. Meh. Meh? Meh. Look, Falcon. I still upset about Dame Catalina's trial, but more moping isn't going to help. The best thing you can do right now would be to occupy yourself with some meaningful work. Because it'll scratch that itch perfectly. Meh. I'm not going to hear it. Grab your things. We're doing this case. I have to drag you by the sleeve. No need to bird handle me. You know what? I totally believe that Sparrowson could like lift him up bodily and drag him to the case. I fully believe this. No more dilly-dallying. Let's go. Good luck to you, messieurs. You aren't coming with us, Mousy? I have other matters to attend to, like begging for food. But Prince Juan is being held in the conciergerie. I'm sure he'll fill you in the details. Make a move. Yes. Yes, let's do that. Yes. La conciergerie! Okay. Good day, monsieur. Oh, it's you two again. Yes, Quark. Oh, fuck me, running. Oh, that was a hiccup, wasn't it? It's really annoying. Yep, I got hiccups. That's great. That is fucking brilliant. By which I mean, this is fucking awful. I hate having hiccups. Baron Rogil is pacing around a cell right now, ranting about wringing your neck. Well, I'm not surprised. He's super mad, but hey, criminals come to the right of the line, didn't want a death sentence, you probably shouldn't have killed the guy. Oh, you're not here to defend him, are you? Because that would be hilarious. Actually, I had to see Prince Juan... Querido. Heir to the throne of Spain. The mouthy fox that comes around me nuts with his señores and his flamboyant attitude. So the sooner he hangs, the better. You're a dick! Quark, a complete dick. Come on, then, while we're young. I don't think you were ever young, Quark. You look about as old as a bird could. Here he is, the Prince of Spain, reading a copy of, Helsing, by the looks of it. Okay. I am Juan Quirido, to the throne of Espana. And if... There's going to be people who are going to try and correct me, even though I'm deliberately getting it wrong. And he must be the legendary lawyer, Senor J.J. Falcon. Fuck, these hiccups, man. And even say notable. Such humility, I would expect nothing less from an renowned individual such as yourselves. Ah! But let's just get down to business. I trust that my Copaniero, Mousy, explained the situation. Ah! He told us that you've been accused of murder, but we need some further details before we can start our investigation. Ah, of course. What is it you wanted to know? What were you reading before we so rudely interrupted? Now, this book? It's Helsing, Volume 7. The Spanish classic, Don Quixote. I think that's Don Quixote. That's how it's pronounced. Of La Mancha. Don Quixote of La Mancha. Do you know it? Readings for squares. Sorry, Juan, but no time for reading in today's fast-paced world. James and York, you're missing out on a fascinating tale of one man's chivalry in a world where chivalry is dead. If you don't care for reading, why did you ask about the book? Curiosity, yes, man. I say, then I tell you what, senor, I will lend you this book. Perhaps if your curiosity allows, you can take some out of your day to read a chapter or two. Inicio Hidalgo Don Quixote de la Mancha has been added to your evidence folder. Was there anything else you wanted to know? I probably can't read Spanish. Just saying. Why are you in Paris, asshole? What is going to Paris, Prince Juan? It's on a diplomatic mission. I do not know whether you're familiar with the current events. You may have heard that my country's in a state of turmoil. Condemned to the Spanish throne, a slandering, plotting, backstabbing. It's chaos. Public suffering. So I thought, if I can befriend some French royalty, perhaps even the king himself, maybe I can strengthen my family's name. With the Quirido dynasty restored, I would have a chance of bringing peace to my beautiful nation. Fucking hiccups, man. Well, his plan's gone out the window. It's embarrassing, don't be so rude. No, he is right, I failed terribly. I killed someone. Don't fret, Prince Juan, we'll do everything I've had to clear your name. Do you have another chance to speak to King Louis Philippe? Yes, thank you, Senor Falcon, I'm sure you can do your best. Is there anything else you want to ask? Tell us about the actual murder, since we're here. To be honest, Prince Juan, I'm a little confused as to how a member of royalty could get in so much trouble. Could you walk through the activities on the day of the murder? And try to ignore how loud the music is. Cold misty morning of the 6th of January, I heard that King Louis Philippe was unveiling a new painting at the Palace de Louvre. I know it's the Louvre. And I wished to be the man himself. I'm getting so fucking sick of this hiccup, man. So after a brief straw and picnic in garden, I entered the palace. I found the royal entourage in Louvre's Grand Galerie. And I saw an opportunity after them to humble gift to the king. A rose, an international symbol of passion and virtue. How romantic. What, do you want to fuck the king? But before the king could take it, a rather rude person snatched it from my fingers. It was a royal guard, a dog by the name of Major Howl. Ouch, cried out Major Howl. I've pricked myself upon the thorns of this dastardly flower. Then the major slumped to the floor. His face turned blue, the mouth frothed, and he died. Died straight after being pricked. Straight away, senor. Any poison egg so fast? Neither do I, but clearly the police felt that poison upon the rose was the only logical explanation, and was only witnesses, even the king himself, what could I say to defend myself? Where did this rose come from? I acquired it from a beautiful Parisian flower seller at Les Halles Markets. Les Halles Markets. A girl by the name of Catherine Marie Signe. But surely not suggesting that the flower girl applied poison herself, Senior Falcon. I'm not making any accusations yet, I'm just planning to explore the line of inquiry. Poison grows, do you want to ask something else? Nope, got everything! It's the plan, Big Bird. I have two lines of inquiry. We should head to the scene of the crime, the Palace of the Louvre, and see if we can find any witnesses, and we should interview the flower girl. Poison grows. Two tasks for over 6 days, that sounds almost too easy, let's not get complacent. Good luck, seniors. Right, good. Wait a minute, Falcon! What is it? Did something seem off about Prince Juan to you? Yeah, he's almost certainly not the Prince of Spain. I can't remember if he's not the Prince of Spain, but he's almost certainly not the Prince of Spain. I don't know, just the way the story's going, it just seems weird that it would be the Prince of Spain. You know what I mean? sounds like we're on the same page. Well, look, if this is bothering you, you could always ask around. Maybe someone that's seen as Juan's dirty secret.
If you actually have anything to hide, that is. Fucking yawn and a hiccup.
Yeah, what's going on? We've still got a child to prepare for. Priorities, person. Okay. It's now the Tuesday. And this is a bit shorter than the other episodes, but unfortunately I'm going to have to call it here because I'm hiccuping, which means I need to take a break from recording. Until this hiccup goes away. So, that's going to be all for me for now. I've been your mother, so I think I just keep going on today. Well, I hope you enjoyed this video as much as I enjoyed making it. Well, I say that, I could have been having a terrible day when I made this video. You can't tell, and I certainly can't. Pre-recorded message and all that. All the same, if you're interested in seeing some live streaming stuff from me, if you look in the description, there'll be a link to my Twitch page, as well as a link to my Twitter in case you want to keep up with all the random gibberish I spew throughout the week. And if you're feeling particularly generous, you can always donate to my Patreon campaign, also linked in the description. Well, that's all from me. This video's over. Leave. Now. Now!
Do not seek the sideways thinker. Do not seek the pardoner.